Today, President Erdogan of Turkey visited Cyprus on this day, the 47th anniversary of the Turkish occupation. Why did he come? Was it to negotiate in good faith for a solution to the division of the island? No. Did he come to apologize for the occupation, the continued occupation of the island? No. He came to announce the reopening of the beach town of Varosha in direct contravention of United Nations Security Council Resolution 550, which, quote, considers attempts to settle any part of Varosha by people other than its inhabitants as inadmissible, end quote. Varosha was once a bustling resort town. It was an international tourist destination in the Famagusta district of the Republic of Cyprus. But with the advance of Turkey's invading forces to the town in August of 1974, Varosha's native Greek Cypriot population fled for their lives. Erdogan's visit is a cynical and shameful act designed to mock the rightful inhabitants of Varosha and to advance Turkey's agenda of dividing Cyprus into two separate states, instead of pursuing a bizonal, bicommunal federation that all parties of good faith have endorsed. I urge the Biden administration to use all means at its disposal to resist Turkey's creeping partition of Cyprus and to bring international condemnation to these outrageous steps that President Erdogan is taking, which disrespect and violate the rights and dignity of the refugees of Varosha. One day, Cyprus will be reunited, but that can only come with the forceful leadership of the American government, deployed consistently, morally, and with an abiding sense of justice.